lie and you get into heaven. Lies have their part to make you fight. And I've told lies, and I'm sure you have. I mean, looking at me, I don't know if you've noticed, but I've got a wedding ring on my hand, okay? Now, I'm a married man. Do you think that I've ever made my wife cry before? What do you think? I have, yeah. Do you think that these fists here, do you think they've ever hit anyone before? What do you think? They have, yeah? But then ask me if I'm going to heaven. I am, not because I'm good, but because there's two types of people that get to heaven. Perfect people and forgiven people. Now, none of us are perfect, as you admit it. We can all be forgiven, because 2,000 years ago, this man Jesus, he hung on a cross, and he took all the wrong things you've done. What's your name, sorry? Jake, is it? Craig. He took all the wrong things Craig's done, all the wrong things Joe's done, and he was punished on that cross. He shed his blood on that cross so you could be forgiven. And he promises, anyone who calls out to him, he promises to save them. Would you ever think about doing that, Craig? All you have to do in the quietness of your home is call out to him, promises to save you. Let me put one final challenge to the skeptic, one final challenge to the atheist. What would you think of me if I said to you now, Harry Potter's a terrible book? What would you think of me, Craig, if I said that? You'd agree with me. What's your name? Adam. Adam would agree with me if I said Harry Potter's a terrible book. Okay, Adam, what if I said Harry Potter is a terrible book, but I've never read it before? What would you think of me then? You'd say, well, read it first, Joe, and then make a decision, and then do it. Please, I'm just saying to anyone going by, don't say the Bible's a load of rubbish without reading it for yourself.